पोटेशियम पर मैंगनेट KMnO4। पोटेशियम पर मैंगनेट इज द इनऑर्गेनिक केमिकल कंपाउंड विद द फॉर्मूला KMnO4। इट इज अ सॉल्ट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ पोटेशियम एंड पर मैंगनेट आयंस के पॉजिटिव एंड MnO4 नेगेटिव। प्रीवियसली इट वॉज ऑल्सो नोन एज परमैंगनेट ऑफ पोटाश और कॉन्डेज क्रिस्टल।
स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू टुडेज एपिसोड ऑन प्रेपरेशन एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ पोटाशियम परमैंगनेट। स्टूडेंट्स मैंगनीज प्रेजेंट इन पोटाशियम परमैंगनेट इज लोकेटेड इन डी ब्लॉक ऑफ द पीरियोडिक टेबल। नाउ वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट्स ऑफ मैंगनीज इन वेरियस ऑक्साइड्स and its effect on the ionic character of its oxides and their acidic nature.
Students, ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਐਪੀਸੋਡ ਵਿੱਚ ਟ੍ਰਾਂਜ਼ੀਸ਼ਨ ਐਲੀਮੈਂਟਸ ਬਾਰੇ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਕਰ ਚੁੱਕੇ ਹਾਂ। ਪੀਰੀਓਡਿਕ ਟੇਬਲ ਵਿੱਚ ਡੀ ਬਲੌਕ ਦੀ ਪਹਿਲੀ ਟ੍ਰਾਂਜ਼ੀਸ਼ਨ ਸੀਰੀਜ਼ ਵਿੱਚ ਮੈਂਗਨੀਜ਼ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੈਂਟ ਹੈ। ਐਪੀਸੋਡ ਦੇ ਇਸ ਹਿੱਸੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਡੀ ਬਲੌਕ ਐਲੀਮੈਂਟਸ ਦੇ ਆਕਸਾਈਡਸ ਬਾਰੇ ਗੱਲ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ। ਪਹਿਲੀ ਟ੍ਰਾਂਜ਼ੀਸ਼ਨ ਸੀਰੀਜ਼ ਦੇ ਮੈਟਲਸ ਨੂੰ ਆਕਸੀਜਨ ਦੀ ਪ੍ਰੈਜੈਂਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਗਰਮ ਕਰਨ ਨਾਲ ਆਕਸਾਈਡਸ ਬਣਦੇ ਹਨ। ਇਹਨਾਂ ਆਕਸਾਈਡਸ ਦਾ ਆਕਸੀਡੇਸ਼ਨ ਨੰਬਰ +1 ਤੋਂ +7 ਵਿੱਚ ਵੈਰੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ। ਜਨਰਲੀ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਸੀਨ ਦੈਟ ਦਾ ਹਾਈਐਸਟ ਆਕਸੀਡੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਦੀਜ ਆਕਸਾਈਡਸ ਮੇ ਬੀ ਈਕੁਅਲ ਟੂ ਦਾ ਨੰਬਰ ਆਫ ਦੈਟ ਪਰਟੀਕੁਲਰ ਗਰੁੱਪ। ਫੋਰ ਐਗਜ਼ਾਮਪਲ manganese remains present in group 7 and its highest oxidation number is +7 in Mn2O7 manganese oxide +7 Mn2O7। students chalo d block di first transition series de ik hor element de oxidation number nu recall karde ha। man lovo ए है आयरन। सो इज द Fe2O3 विच हायर ऑक्सीडेशन +3 होवेगा। यह जानना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि बियॉन्ड ग्रुप 7 नो हायर ऑक्साइड ऑफ आयरन अबव Fe2O3 इज नोन। विखाई जा रही इमेज विच असी मैंगनीज दे वेरियस ऑक्साइड्स वेख रहे हाँ। इन्ना सारे ऑक्साइड्स विच मैंगनीज़ दा ऑक्सीडेशन भी डिपिक्ट कीता गया है। विखाया गया है कि MnO विच मैंगनीज़ दी ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट +2 है, जबकि ए Mn2O7 विच +7 ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट दर्शाउंदा है। MnO तो Mn2O7 विच शोन मैनर विच आयोनिक करैक्टर डिक्रीज होंदा है। ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर इनक्रीज होने नाल आयोनिक करैक्टर डिक्रीज हुंदा है। आफ्टर स्टडिंग अबाउट ऑक्सीडेशन स्टेट्स ऑफ मैंगनीज ऑक्साइड्स एंड देयर आयोनिक करैक्टर, नाउ वी विल फोकस ऑन देयर एसिडिक करैक्टर। एसिडिक करैक्टर इनक्रीजेज इन द शोन मैनर फ्रॉम MnO टू Mn2O7। फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ MnO। As we know, manganese is shown to have +2 oxidation state in MnO. It is basic in nature. Similarly, we can see nature of other oxides of manganese too on the screen. This has been depicted here that Mn2O7 is acidic in nature. With the increase in oxidation number, acidic character also increases.
After studying about the manganese oxides, now let us see how potassium permanganate can be prepared.
Preparation of KMnO4. Manganese dioxide bataur mineral pyroleucite milda hai. Pyroleucite ek mineral hai jis vich mukh taur te manganese dioxide yani MnO2 hundi hai. Ate ਇਹ ਮੈਂਗਨੀਜ਼ ਦੀ ਇੱਕ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਔਰ ਹੈ। ਮੈਂਗਨੀਜ਼ ਡਾਈਆਕਸਾਈਡ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਹਾਈਡਰੋਕਸਾਈਡ ਨਾਲ ਫਿਊਜ਼ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਅਤੇ ਹਵਾ ਵਿੱਚ ਗਰਮ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ ਅਤੇ ਪਾਣੀ ਬਣਾਉਂਦੀ ਹੈ। ਮੈਂਗਨੀਜ਼ ਡਾਈਆਕਸਾਈਡ ਆਲਸੋ ਗੈਟਸ ਫਿਊਜ਼ਡ ਵਿਦ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਕਾਰਬੋਨੇਟ ਐਂਡ ਹੀਟਿਡ ਇਨ ਏਅਰ ਟੂ ਗਿਵ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ ਐਂਡ ਕਾਰਬਨ ਡਾਈਆਕਸਾਈਡ। ਮੈਂਗਨੀਜ਼ ਡਾਈਆਕਸਾਈਡ ਆਲਸੋ ਰਿਐਕਟਸ ਵਿਦ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਹਾਈਡਰੋਕਸਾਈਡ ਐਂਡ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਨਾਈਟ੍ਰੇਟਸ ਟੂ ਗਿਵ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ, ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਨਾਈਟ੍ਰਾਈਟ ਐਂਡ ਵਾਟਰ। ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ ਆਲਸੋ ਗੈਟਸ ਫਾਰਮਡ ਵੈਨ ਮੈਂਗਨੀਜ਼ ਡਾਈਆਕਸਾਈਡਸ ਰਿਐਕਟਸ ਵਿਦ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਹਾਈਡਰੋਕਸਾਈਡ ਐਂਡ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਕਲੋਰੇਟਸ। ਇਹ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੈਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ ਬਣਦਾ ਹੈ, ਜੋ ਕਿ ਐਲਕਲਾਈਨ ਸੋਲਿਊਸ਼ਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਲੈਕਟ੍ਰੋਲਿਟਿਕ ਆਕਸੀਡੇਸ਼ਨ ਦੁਆਰਾ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਪਰ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ ਬਣਾਉਂਦਾ ਹੈ। ਵੈਨ ਦਸ ਫਾਰਮਡ ਪੋਟਾਸ਼ੀਅਮ ਪਰ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਅਲਾਊਡ ਟੂ ਸਟੈਂਡ ਫੋਰ ਸਮ ਟਾਈਮ, ਇਟ ਅੰਡਰਗੋਜ਼ ਡਿਸਪ੍ਰਪੋਰਸ਼ਨ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਨਿਊਟਰਲ ਐਂਡ ਐਸਿਡਿਕ ਸੋਲਿਊਸ਼ਨ। ਇਨ ਦਿਸ ਕੈਮੀਕਲ ਰਿਐਕਸ਼ਨ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ ਆਇਨਸ ਰਿਐਕਟ ਵਿਦ ਹਾਈਡਰੋਜਨ ਆਇਨਸ ਟੂ ਫਾਰਮ ਪਰ ਮੈਂਗਨੇਟ ਆਇਨਸ, ਮੈਂਗਨੀਜ਼ ਡਾਈਆਕਸਾਈਡ ਐਂਡ ਵਾਟਰ।
Oxidation of potassium permanganate takes place by two methods, chemical oxidation and electrical oxidation. First, we will discuss chemical oxidation of potassium manganate to permanganate.
The fused mass of potassium manganate is extracted with water and after filtration, the solution is converted into potassium permanganate by bubbling carbon dioxide, chlorine gas or ozonized water. Out of these methods, in carbon dioxide method, yield of potassium permanganate is low, as 1/3 part of original manganate is converted to manganese dioxide. But this process has one advantage too. Potassium carbonate is formed as a byproduct and can be used for the oxidative fusion of manganese dioxide. In the second chemical reaction in chlorine process, potassium chloride is obtained as a byproduct. In the electrolytic oxidation, the alkaline manganate solution is electrolyzed between iron electrodes separated by diaphragm. The reactions taking place are as follows. Potassium permanganate dissociates to form potassium ions and manganate ions, and water dissociates to form hydrogen ions and hydroxyl ions. At anode, manganate ions changes to permanganate ions by oxidation and electrons are released. At cathode, hydrogen ions takes electrons to get reduced and hydrogen gas is released. After complete oxidation, the solution is filtered and evaporated, and finally we get crystals of potassium permanganate.
Now, let us discuss laboratory preparation of potassium permanganate. In the laboratory method, potassium permanganate is prepared by the oxidation of manganese ions salt by
peroxydisulfide.
Ionic reactions involved in this method are shown here. After knowing about the various methods of the preparation of potassium permanganate, now we will discuss properties of potassium permanganate. First, let us start with physical properties. Potassium permanganate exists as deep purple black prisms with a greenish luster which becomes dull in air due to reduction. It is moderately soluble in water at room temperature and it is more soluble in hot water. In this part of the episode, we will discuss action of heat, concentrated sulfuric acid, hydrogen and ethanol on potassium permanganate one by one. First, we will see what happens when potassium permanganate is heated.
Action of heat. Students, when potassium permanganate is heated to 513 Kelvin temperature, it readily decomposes to give potassium manganate, manganese dioxide, and oxygen gas. On further heating, this potassium manganate again decomposes to potassium manganite and oxygen gas is released.
Students, do you know what happens when dilute and concentrated sulfuric acid reacts with potassium permanganate?
Let us take crystals of potassium permanganate in a bowl and add dilute sulfuric acid into it. We see the crystals of potassium permanganate starts burning. It is an explosive reaction.
Now, we will discuss about the chemical reactions involved when potassium permanganate solution reacts with cool as well as hot concentrated sulfuric acid. First, we will discuss action of cool and concentrated sulfuric acid on potassium permanganate. When potassium permanganate reacts with cool and concentrated sulfuric acid, it forms manganese oxide, which decomposes to form manganese dioxide. While when potassium permanganate reacts with hot and concentrated sulfuric acid, it forms potassium sulfate, manganese sulfate, water, and oxygen gas. Now, we will discuss action of hydrogen on potassium permanganate. On heating with hydrogen, potassium permanganate forms potassium hydroxide, manganese oxide, and water.
Let us see how ethanol reacts with potassium permanganate. Action of ethanol. Let us take a measuring cylinder and add sulfuric acid into it. Add ethanol solution to it. But care should be taken. It should be added slowly. Now, add crystals of potassium permanganate into it. At molecular level, a redox reaction takes place and we can see bubbles in the test tube when potassium permanganate crystals react. A change in color is also noticed. It is due to the change in oxidation state of manganese. We can also see burning of oxygen. Finally, solution turns green. It is not possible to perform this test in the laboratory. So, we should be careful while performing this test.
Oxidizing property. Potassium permanganate acts as a powerful oxidizing agent. Oxidation of potassium permanganate is possible in three types of solutions: neutral, alkaline, acidic. Let's discuss oxidizing property of potassium permanganate into these solutions one by one. In neutral solution, potassium permanganate acts as an oxidizing agent in neutral solution due to the shown chemical reactions. This reaction depicts that potassium permanganate reacts with water to form potassium hydroxide, manganese oxide, and nascent oxygen gas. Or we can also write as permanganate ions react with water and electrons to form manganese dioxide and hydroxyl ions. According to this equation, in neutral medium, 2 moles of permanganate form 3 nascent oxygen atoms. In fact, during the course of reaction, the alkali renders the medium alkaline even when we start with neutral solutions.
Hence, equivalent weight of potassium permanganate in neutral or weakly alkaline medium is 52.67, which is obtained by dividing molecular weight by 3. For example, oxidation of sodium thiosulfate to sodium sulfate. Potassium permanganate reacts with sodium thiosulfate and water to form potassium sulfate, manganese oxide, sodium sulfate, and potassium hydroxide. Students, let us take an animation to study reaction between potassium permanganate solution with 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate solution. Take 10 milliliters of 0.1 molar sodium thiosulfate solution in a conical flask. Add potassium permanganate solution in the conical flask. When sodium thiosulfate reacts with potassium permanganate solution and the solution turns purple due to the presence of potassium permanganate solution in it. But after some time, the solution turns colorless.
In alkaline solution, potassium permanganate reacts with potassium hydroxide to form potassium manganate and water, and nascent oxygen is formed. Ionic equation is also shown on the screen.
According to this equation, in alkaline medium, 2 moles of permanganate form 1 nascent oxygen atom. Hence, equivalent weight of potassium permanganate in alkaline medium is 158, which is obtained by dividing molecular weight by 1.
For example, it oxidizes olefinic compounds to glycols. Alkaline potassium permanganate, KMnO4, used for this test is also known as Bayer's reagent. Ethylene oxidizes with alkaline KMnO4 potassium permanganate to form ethylene glycol.
Let us discuss action with sodium hydroxide and sugar on potassium permanganate solution. Take a conical flask and add sodium hydroxide solution into it. Add some amount of sugar into it. The solution is stirred. Again, add some more amount of sugar into it. Shake the solution well to dissolve sugar completely into it. Again, add potassium permanganate solution into it. What happens? Note the initial color of potassium permanganate solution. It is purple in color. But when it is added into the conical flask having sugar and sodium hydroxide solution, the solution turns green. After some time, the solution color changes to green, and finally this green color disappears and the solution turns colorless. Now we will see action of hydrogen peroxide on potassium permanganate solution. Take potassium permanganate into a conical flask and add hydrogen peroxide solution. It is seen that the white fumes are formed. When same reaction is repeated again and again, white fumes are formed again and again.
In acidic solution, potassium permanganate reacts with sulfuric acid to form potassium sulfate, manganese sulfate, water, and nascent oxygen. Relevant ionic equation is also shown on the screen. According to this equation, in acidic medium, 2 moles of permanganate form 5 nascent oxygen atoms. Hence, equivalent weight of potassium permanganate in acidic medium is 31.6, which is obtained by dividing molecular weight by 5. Potassium permanganate oxidizes to oxalic acid. Let us know about the chemical reactions involved in it.
Potassium permanganate oxidizes oxalic acid to carbon dioxide gas. This reaction takes place in two steps. In first step, potassium permanganate reacts with sulfuric acid to form potassium sulfate, manganese sulfate, water, and nascent oxygen. This is equation number 1. In second step, oxalic acid reacts with nascent oxygen to form water and carbon dioxide. Number this equation as 2. Multiply equation 2 by 5. On adding equation 1 and 2, we get shown chemical equation. Relevant ionic equation is also shown here. Percentage of a given solution of ferrous sulfate can be calculated with the help of potassium permanganate solution by titration method. Materials required to perform this titration are potassium permanganate solution of known strength, ferrous sulfate solution of unknown strength, burette, pipette, conical flask, sulfuric acid. Take 10 milliliters of ferrous sulfate solution of unknown strength in the conical flask with the help of pipette. Add some amount of sulfuric acid in it. Add potassium permanganate solution into it drop by drop with the help of burette. Initially, unoxidized ferrous ions are present in the solution. When potassium permanganate solution comes in contact with unoxidized ferrous ions present in conical flask, the purple color of potassium permanganate solution becomes colorless. In this way, we have seen that at end point, the solution in conical flask turns purple due to complete oxidation of ferrous ions. In this titration, potassium permanganate solution acts as self-indicator. Now, we will see chemical reactions involved in this process. Let us have a look at the structure of permanganate ions. Manganese atom is shown to be surrounded by 4 oxygen atoms. Manganese atom is sp3 hybridized with 4 oxygen atoms, and these 4 oxygen atoms are located at 4 corners of a tetrahedron.
Manganese present in permanganate ion is in +7 oxidation state with d0 electronic configuration.
The purple
color of the potassium permanganate is not due to DD transition, but due to charge transfer from oxygen to manganese. It reduces the oxidation state of manganese from +7 to +6 momentarily. After discussing about the preparation and properties of potassium permanganate, let us discuss uses of potassium permanganate in our daily life. Disinfectant and water treatment. Potassium permanganate solution is used to treat infections. When it is mixed with water, it helps in the treatment of skin conditions, fungal infections, eczema, dermatitis, and ulcers. As an oxidant, potassium permanganate can act as an antiseptic. Wound cleansing. Potassium permanganate ਵੀ wounds ਜਿਵੇਂ ulcers ਅਤੇ abscesses ਦੀ treatment ਵਿੱਚ use ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ। Potassium permanganate ਦੀ broad antimicrobial properties ਕਾਰਨ ਇਹ bacteria, algae ਅਤੇ viruses ਨੂੰ ਮਾਰ ਸਕਦਾ ਹੈ, ਜਿਸ ਨਾਲ secondary wound infections ਦੇ chances decrease ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਨ। Fungal infections. Potassium permanganate nu fungal infections jive athlete's foot the treatment lai vi use kita janda hai, which is also known as ringworm of the foot or tinea pedis. In analytical chemistry, a standardized aqueous solution of potassium permanganate is sometimes used as an oxidizing titrant for redox titrations. These types of titrations are known as permanganometry. For the standardization of potassium permanganate solutions, reduction by oxalic acid is often used.
Students, molarity of oxalic acid can be determined by using m upon 100 molar potassium per manganate solution. Materials required to perform this experiment are oxalic acid solution of unknown molarity, potassium permanganate solution of known molarity m upon 100, sulfuric acid solution of 4N normality, burette and pipette. Take potassium permanganate solution in the burette and attach this burette in the clamp stand. Take 10 milliliters of oxalic acid solution of unknown molarity in the conical flask and add sulfuric acid solution of 4N normality into it. What happens when potassium permanganate solution of known molarity m upon 100 is added into it? The color of potassium permanganate solution turns colorless. At micro level, potassium permanganate is shown reacting with oxalic acid. It is seen that after some time, total amount of oxalic acid solution is used up in this reaction, and the solution turns purple again. This point is known as the end point. Chemical reactions taking place in this experiment are as follows.
Well, students, after studying about preparation and properties of potassium permanganate solution, we will try to recall today's topic with the help of some questions. My first question is, why in the permanganate ion there is a covalency between manganese and oxygen? The answer is, in permanganate ion, manganese is in highest oxidation state. Its oxidation state is plus 7. In high oxidation states, transition metals form covalent bonds. Next question is, why is it not advisable to dissolve potassium permanganate in concentrated sulfuric acid? The answer is, with concentrated sulfuric acid, potassium permanganate reacts to form manganese heptoxide, which on warming decomposes to manganese dioxide.
Next question is, what happens when KMnO4 is heated with A. hot and concentrated H2SO4, B. acidified FeSO4? The answer is, when potassium permanganate reacts with hot and concentrated sulfuric acid, it forms oxygen gas, potassium sulfate, manganese sulfate and water are also released in this reaction. Potassium permanganate reacts with ferrous sulfate in two steps as shown on the screen. My next question is, when MnO2 is fused with KOH, a colored compound is formed. The product and its color is, options are A. K2MnO4 purple green, B. KMnO4 purple, C. Mn2O3 brown, or D. Mn2O4 black. The answer is, the product is K2MnO4 purple green. Next question is, number of electrons transferred in each case when potassium permanganate acts as an oxidizing agent to give manganese dioxide, dipositive manganese ion, manganese hydroxide and dinegative permanganate ion are respectively. Options are A, 3, 5, 4 and 1, B, 4, 3, 1 and 5, C, 1, 3, 4 and 5, or D, 5, 4, 3 and 1? The answer is option A, 3, 5, 4 and 1. Next question is, potassium permanganate acts as an oxidizing agent in A, acidic medium only, B, neutral and acidic medium, C, neutral and alkaline medium, or D, neutral, acidic and alkaline medium. The answer is option C. Potassium permanganate acts as an oxidizing agent in neutral, acidic and alkaline medium.
Well, students, I hope that you all have learned a lot about potassium permanganate. Next time, we will again come back with a new topic. Till then, bye.